Okay, I've done the color, I think. You could have this leaves more individualized, but I like the kind of misty feel, like off focus feel. This is the focus, so we just leave that as is. And we can not do the background wash and the statement before I do that. We can use a small brush.
How do you put these things on?
Oh, I just painted painted on this dry brush, yeah. And then I kind of melt into water.
Mm.
You can. I think you have. You have
I
to
think
I'll
leave mine.
Yeah.
Yes.
Because yours is different. You can leave that. This. I like the one you got. Because I have this flat. Background to begin with. That's why I do that. Like
it's beautifully blended, that green.
I use water brush to blend it.
All this here.
Mm-hmm. All this here?
Mm.
Yeah, you use double brush, I mean separate brush to do the wash. And okay, now I'm going to do is to use some white. You have to use plenty of white. So
okay.
White to make it opaque, and orange color or
yellow. You might have some floating around.
Yeah.
There's some there. If you want to dig into that.
Yeah, I can.
I'll get rid of the blue.
Okay. Let me just get from the tube. It's easier. Here. I got too much. So white. Make sure the brush is clean.
Mm-hmm.
This is tender brush. Very easy. Completely clean brush. You may need to clean the water for me. Let's see. I just use whatever clean brush in hand with a sharp point. And you need to make a full load or adequate amount that it's so much color, so the color will build up on the surface of the paper to let it dry before. Okay, so it's not just a flat stroke, it's to build up. So you need to do. And this one.
Do you want to look at a picture?
I know that. It's just here. Right here in the middle. So it's not on the anywhere.
To either side of that.
Outside. Yeah, just the inside. Right here. And just a couple more.
Will I do the same thing here?
Yeah. Okay, just. And on this one, I may add a little green to start with as a preparation. So,
you don't add much yellow?
Okay, I mean the background.
For this
yellow and the. Yeah, yellow. There's the yellow and the white on this one only. On this back one, I would use some green to wash the center, like the seat area. But you have to let it dry. That's the problem. Otherwise you cannot do the statement. So you can wash a little green. Make a little contrast because the white will not show otherwise. And dry a little bit. I use my to dry it. Now I can do the yellow. You can add a little orange color, I think. Okay. Okay, that's it. You can see that. So there's the warm and the cold yellow difference between the two. There's no orange in the front one. Give you some more white. I'll just put that on here.
That's good. I'm getting it from here.
Okay.
Thank you. How does that seem, Henry?
Very good. Nice. I like that.
I have to fix this one up here. It's not opaque enough.
Is that the right spot you're doing? It should be under the top.
No!
Look at the spot. Under the top.
Yes.
It should be inside. More inside.
Here.
Under. This, where? Here is fine. But not on top. Looks like, for me, you're doing... Makes the pedal looks yellow. I don't know why. But look at check this.
Yeah.
This inside where you're hidden.
I thought that's where I've got it.
Yeah, you got. Okay. Because maybe I was wrong. So.
I don't know.
Let it dry. So this dot should be raised on top of the paper. So if it's too thick, won't do it. It have to be right moisture. So it would be three dimensional kind of.
Is that better?
Actually. Just too much on top, that's the problem. You can kind of cover all the top. This is the top. That top pedal should be...
This pedal here?
Yeah, this stem should not go beyond.
Oh, I see. I can fix that.
Yeah, you can use white. And use, I don't know, you can blot it away. Or
just blot it away.
And then you do that. You
it needs to be darker than whatever it is anyway.
Let it dry or see.
I might grab another tissue if I can.
There's a yellow flower. You can make the flower more.
We've got some
tissue.
Oh,
yeah, you get
the
tissue. Yeah, tissue. Okay. So I'm going to wash the background at the same time. The pen is doing her stainings. So let me clean this water first. All right, now I'm going to wash my background. This is not too special, just
I see what you put. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I can use double brush or just use a single brush, but you need to make plenty of the color, I think, you need to get. I'll just use indigo here. Oops, some dots.
Yes, I need some indigo too.
Yeah, I would wash the sky first. It's not going to create a hard line. And I will blend into it. Now I use the indigo to do the foreground. And you can wet the area you're going to do first, a little dampen it. You know. Then I do this area first. Wet into wet is easier. But if you want void brushes, you dampen the whole thing.
Oh, I see. It's a bit scary.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's easy. You just have to void the petals in this sort of area. So just let it dry. Don't wet the whole area. Just let it dry here. So
Is that a bit better? Mm-hmm.
Yeah, much better. Right. That's what I mean. So I void carefully the petals and leaves. Maybe.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Very carefully.
Yeah. Okay. Now
they've just got some strokes in there, so.
Yeah, just add water to dilute. Just horizontal strokes, you know. Okay. And it don't have to be even. To make this, the water feel ripples. But it should be very smooth water, like a mirror.
There we are. It's very strange.
You can use light green, a bit blue, and then darken it.
I wonder what would suit this the best.
Mm-hmm.
I think the blue.
The blue.
Mm.
Yeah, this area is requiring more care to avoid the petals. And you can use double brush. I just use one brush with the bottom of the brush very light.
That's about it. Now, do we have to do the whole lot?
I think 2/3 of it, and leave the top as empty sky. So I go through all the petals, then I use the bottom of the brush.
How's that? Is that going to be dark enough?
You can add to it. That's what I started with. You can repeat several times if it's not enough, just like you do with other parts. If you want to make it even, usually you have to repeat. But it don't have to even, you know.
I'll try and melt that little mistake away.
Yeah, definitely. So, I think we should have another leaf here. Remote leaf. Oh, it's wet in here, so it has to be careful.
I'm banking on the fact that the crinkles will come out.
Crinkles will be flattened with mounting. Don't worry about that. I have a folding line here, that's the problem. you have a stroke, shows that, then it would be a problem. So if you wet it, it should be okay. I think I go too far, so I will just stop here. So the flower should be in the sky, in above the horizon. The petal.
The bud.
Yeah, the bud should be the above the horizon line. So that's why where I stop.
Right. Well, I think I'll do the same.
Okay. Yeah. Don't just have a gradation from bottom to top. The right bottom bottom should be dark. Yeah. And it will dry, just like a watercolor, it will dry, dry lighter, so it will do a little stronger.
Oops.
Then you
scratch. I've got to get in here. I've got to get into all these little crevices here.
Okay, we just finished this Gombe painting together, and Pam is going to sign her version, and I will sign mine later. And let's take a look of her painting. And we have decided to sign on the left corner, and she put a sample I wrote in the first day workshop as a reference, so she can write.
Yep.
Eventually she will write automatically, but now she use that as reference, just like a Gombe template. You can use that. Just make sure you do it right and with precisioning everything. Good. So we're going to do the seal next. Under the signature. That's right. The mark on the left orientation would be correct.
Right.
Yeah, just dab a little more. Don't press, just dab gently, and then you can check. And then blow some moisture from your mouth. And press it carefully, align with the character. Press gently and firmly. Hold the paper with your left hand fingers and thumb and your index finger holding the paper while you lift it straight. Perfect. Very good. Wow. Let's take a picture now.
Has Cappy had his dinner? And he's drunk all his drink as well.
Yes. Yeah. Can you pass me the sealed pad? Yeah. Thank you. Thank you. Okay. I'm going to inscribe this painting We just finished last try. I would describe or put a corner seal here, as here, I think we just write on top of it. We can write horizontally because it's a square-ish composition, so that may be good. We don't have to write in dark because it's in the distance. So we try to dilute it. Fragrance, breeze, gently, field, like the signature in your name, field.
Oh, yes.
Field, yeah. Man. Mirror, or mirror lake, lake as mirror.
It's very peaceful.
Peaceful lake.
Yeah,
we call it mirror
very,
lake.
Very quiet, very calm, like a mirror-like.
Mirror-like,
not big
oh, mirror-like. Yeah, thank you, Victoria. Mirror-like lake.
No,
fragrance, breeze, gently, breathing gently, filled the mirror-like lake. That's a poem. Victoria just wrote.
Came up with, yes.
Yeah, so this is the year. And this nice autumn. Henry. Signature. All my seal. Chinese names. My friend Da Tong, my college classmate, made this for me. He's in Nanjing. We're going to meet in November again.
Oh. Are you going back to China in November? Who minds Cappy?
Sent to the daycare.
Oh, yes, to daycare. And what about Ben?
Ben, we didn't know yet, probably neighbor.
Oh.
Yeah, because Cappy need more, walk. We sent him to.
Okay, that's the...
Now, I want to see the way you've done that fill.
Yeah. So... Can you see the composition now? It's good.
Yes.
Yeah. This seal is my...
Where's this word fill? Filled.
Oh, the man.
Oh, man. It's this filled.
Oh, that's not the same as that.
Yeah.
Same capital.
Oh, I put
a little bit different.
Oh, this is good. Oh, there it is there.
Yeah.
Okay, so...
See? You can recognize, right? Even a little bit different.
Yeah.
This is the character.
Okay. And let me...
I should have done that a bit finer.
No,
but that's
no,
all
right. It's okay.
No, I think it's fine, yeah.
It's perfect.
Yeah.
Okay, now I will put another corner seal, which is a sudden alignment.
Hmm?
Yeah.
It's what?
Sudden alignment.
Huoran ke.
Oh.
Sudden alignment.
Is this going into a frame?
Oh, yeah, we could. If we, we,
you must have hundreds of these things from workshops.
Yeah, I will try to sell it on our website also.
Oh, or on eBay?
Yeah.
Do you find eBay successful for selling paintings?
Yeah, I sell a few. Do you think that we should put here or here?
I think left hand
side. Left hand side, yeah.
That looks very swank, that seal, doesn't it?
The big one.
Yeah, this one I did also in the same period when I was in college, like in my early 20s, in early 80s, 1980s. It's one of my oldest seal, my favorite too.
Is it?
Yeah. I didn't have computer design, I had...
Oh, it's, yes, it's lovely.
Yeah. It's
beautiful.
Like...
Beautiful.
Mm-hmm. Thank you. Okay, now let's take an overall look with the seal and the signature. Let me just put here.
Very lovely.
Your piece are really lovely as well. I like your better. I was better. Yes.
Me too.
From the painting, you can tell the process. The patience people has during the painting time during the process.
Yeah, it's
and the
reflection of
the
mood.
Right. Everything.
I tried to put some of the brown marks on the leaves that Henry's got looking absolutely beautiful, and I could see if I went on with it I was going to really cause a fair bit of damage to what I'd done, so we thought, no, we'll leave well.